The Center of Excellence has continued to take giant strides in every facet of life, despite all odds. One of the factors that have made this possible is the aspiration of the BRF administration, which remains infrastructure renewal as a means of poverty alleviation. Governor Fashola's vision is to make Lagos the Venice of Africa, whereby Lagos State would become the best place to live, work, and enjoy the bounties of life, particularly in the whole of Nigeria and Africa in general. At the same time, Lagos State government has kept faith with its goal of bringing democracy dividends to its more than 20 million inhabitants as far as probity, accountability, transparency, justice, rule of law, and equity are concerned. However, considering its ever-growing population and the attendant commensurate pressure on social infrastructure, the BRF administration, being proactive, continues to adopt practical measures in tackling emergency challenges. One of such measures is the utilization of funds received from excess crude and budget augmentation from the Federation account, which is no longer news. With the positive ripple effects of the utilization of the excess crude funds, particularly that of 2007 to mid-2011, the state government has again deployed funds for January 2011 to December 2012 for sensitive ongoing and new projects that are targeted at the masses. Now, let's take a short excursion into these projects being undertaken by various ministries, parastatals, and offices within the administrative structure of the Lagos State Government. Ministry of Health. Construction of roads, internal drainage, network facility at Lasuth Annex, facility management of Lasuth, 1st January to December 31st. Completion of the new fence at Gbagada General Hospital and an additional work on the construction of four-story, 100-bed maternal and child health complex at Ikorodu General Hospital. Ministry of Energy and Mineral Resources. Extension of Island Power Project to Sura, Simpson Street, Lagos Island. Lighting installation from Lagos High Court and extension of Island Power Project to connect City Hall from Island Maternity. Ministry of Women Affairs. Construction of Skills Acquisition Center in Ilashe Town. Ministry of Works. Rehabilitation and upgrading of Glover Road, Ikoyi in Etiosa. Rehabilitation of Sonya Adetola Brown, Idowu Odunuga, Akombi and Adebola Ojomo in Surulere local government area. Construction of Idiatu, Sandra, Mabadeje Irewumi and Karonwi Streets in Ikorodu local government area. Construction of Miyaki Road, Owurunshuki in Koshofe local government area. Rehabilitation and upgrading of Mera Road, Phase 1 in Alimosho local government area. Rehabilitation of Olateju Street in Mushi. Construction of access road to Olushosu dump site in Ojota and Ekpe dump site in Ekpe local government area. Construction of Abuliado Road in Amuwodofin local government area. Rehabilitation of Kasali Oluwo Street in Ekpe local government area, among so many others. Office of Infrastructure. Construction of Kushenla Ojulari Road in Etiosa local government area. Rehabilitation and upgrading of Akinrinlo Adenuga Kajero Street in Shomolu local government area. Construction of Agufoye Road, Igbogbo, Phase 1, Ikorodu local government area. Construction of Akpata Street, Okera, in Ikeja local government area, and Akishemoye Street in Surulere. Rehabilitation of Joel Ogunaike Street in Ikeja GRA. Thank you. La Mata. Construction and rehabilitation of Sinari Daranijo Street, Victoria Island. New Towns Development Authority. Site preparation of Sports City Stadium Complex in Ifakoijai Local Government Area. Office of Sports. Redevelopment of Agege Stadium, Phase 1. Ministry of Science and Technology. Procurement of dedicated internet, backup power and other accessories. Benefits of the dynamic manner of administration of the present government in Lagos State, one would easily and undoubtedly agree that this move to channel available resources to crucial areas of need is indeed a wise one. Apart from the creation of employment opportunities to various professionals in various fields, cutting across all sectors, most especially infrastructure, environment, health, education, engineering, sports, science and technology, energy, transport, and many more, there is the stimulation of economic activities involving hundreds of thousands of those who are directly or indirectly involved in these wide-ranging projects. Also, tactfully disbursing the excess crude funds has not only helped to save budgeted monies for other vital projects, it has also filled a vacuum of delay that any of these projects could have suffered as a result of limited funds chasing so many critical projects. Finally, using excess crude to satisfy the yearnings and aspirations of Lagosians simply means that the BRF administration is one with a human face. After all, that is what good governance is all about.